my channel. Today I am going to show you a review and a haul of things that I've bought the past week. And if you're interested in what I've got, just keep on watching. So, I have gotten a few things off the Morphe website and I wanted to show you what I got. So, I wanted to start off with the biggest one, of course, because that's the most fun. It's the Morphe 35K palette. And why I wanted to buy this was because I needed a few more like neutral shades. And I wanted a bunch of them so I could like mix and match them and just build up rounds for like different looks. So that's why I chose this palette. It looks like this. And they all have like these like brown shades. And we do have like some silvers and blacks and some like champagne colors up here just to tie the whole palette together. I really like this palette. I've actually used it on my eyes today, and I'll insert a little clip for you just to, so you could see what I did. But mainly I used this color in my crease for a transition shade, sorry. And then I used this one just all over my lid and up in the crease as well. And then I went over to this one a little bit, and then I went down here and I grabbed a little bit of this. I think a bit of this and a bit of that. So I used a lot just for this simple look, but that's just what I wanted. I wanted to be able to like make a look using like 7 different eyeshadows just to make it as soft as possible. And I think it kind of looks seamless as well. So that's really what I wanted for this palette. And I also used this highlighting shade in the inner corner just to get a little bit of like a highlighted effect. So I did use this palette before this, and I also will show you a swatch of all the colors at the end of this video, just if you want to see how they all look like. But I really like this palette. It's really like creamy and buttery, and it's really just what I like. And if you haven't tried out Morphe yet, you really should try to get your hands on them. I live in Sweden, so I have to just get off their website, and it does take a while to get here, and shipping isn't that cheap, but I think it's worth it because there are like these are like great eyeshadows, and it's not expensive at all. It was like, I think I got it on a little bit of a sale. It was like during the holidays, I think I got it for $28 or $29 or something like that. And that's like crazy because it's 35 eyeshadows in here. So they're less than a dollar each, which is just crazy. I just can't really believe that. But that's true. So if you're interested in just getting like any of the 35 palettes that they have, I know that 35O is like so popular and everybody wants one. But if you're interested in just getting another one, if you don't like all those warm shades, this one is really great. I really like this one, so I would really recommend that. And then I also got some brushes from the Morphe site, and I have used these, so they're not very clean at the moment. I just wanted to use them before this video so I could just talk about them, like really give you my opinion on them. I did get the M433 brush, which is a blending brush. It's really similar to the MAC 217, which I also have, which I used today, which is all dirty. But they are kind of similar in shape. The M433 is a bit more fluffy, I would say, and rounder, as the MAC is a bit, like it has a flatter side. And it's kind of like a wider, I would say, like an oval shade. A shape, sorry, instead of a round. So that's the difference. So you could get a bit more precise with the MAC one. But I really like this one. It blends out your shadows like crazy. You don't really have to go in there and work for a long time. It just blends out them so much easier. So I really recommend this. And I think the hairs are like goat hair, which I don't really like because I want to try to stay out of animal hair in my brushes. But I need to looking out for that, because the ones that I have tried without like that are synthetic hairs, I just haven't really been so like blown away by them. So I'm still for the lookout for that. But yeah, this is the Morphe M433, and I really like this. And it is, how much was it? I think it was like maybe $6 or $7, and compared to the MAC, it's like $17 or something like that. So it's definitely worth it. So if you're wondering if you should get the MAC 217 or the Morphe 433, I would really recommend this over the MAC one, since it is so much cheaper. And then I also got the Morphe 166 brush. It's a flat shading brush, and it's not really the brush I was looking for when I ordered this online. I wanted like a flat shading brush so I could pack on like glitter shades, a synthetic one that would just not hold so much product and just distribute it on my my eyelids instead. And I just don't feel like this is doing the job, and I think I just picked the wrong one. It's so hard to see online what they really look like. I think this would be flat, but it's not. It's like kind of fat and too big as well. I wanted like half the size of this, and I haven't really tried it out too much, so I can't really say if I like it or not. But right now it's not doing what I want it to do. So we'll see about this when I'll come back to you. I mean, it could be just a great brush to pack on like skin colored eyeshadow for my base. Didn't do the job that I wanted it to do, so we'll see about this one. And I think this one was also like $5 or $6. I'll check it out and I put it in the description box down below if you want to see how much it really was. It would definitely work out if you just want to use matte shades and put that on the lid. So the next brush is I think it says on the website it is a big like fluffy blending brush or something like that, but I'm using this for highlighting on my cheeks and on my face and stuff like this. And that is the Morphe M501 brush. Looks like this. It's really fluffy, and I just load that up on my brush. I can just show you really quick. Just loading it up like this and then tapping that off and just dusting it on my cheekbones. And it really fits very, very well right on the cheekbones, I think. And it kind of gives like a subtle highlight. It doesn't become streaky or anything, and I really like it. It's very soft. I do like this brush. It works really nice on highlighting on the cheekbones and on my nose and cupid's bow and chin and every place you want a highlight. So I really recommend this. If you're on the lookout for a good highlighting brush, I would really recommend this, the M501 brush. So yeah, and I think this was a bit more than the other ones, like maybe $8 or $9, but it's not much. It's not much for a brush. And this quality is really good. It does feel very professional and like with a good quality and stuff like that, which is just crazy for the price. I don't really get it, but all the brushes that I've tried from Morphe are like so good quality, and I don't have any fallout from the hairs. Maybe I had like a good one brush at one time for the time that I've been having them. So I think they're really worth the price. And if you do live abroad, like not in America, I think it's worth to pay for shipping for them, even though it sucks. But yeah, so these are the brushes that I got, and I'm really happy that I got them, especially these two. Not this one that much, but we'll see. Maybe I'll start to loving it soon. I'll get back to you on that. And then I also got a pair of lashes from the Morphe website while I was still on it. And it's the Flutter Lashes, the Ersatz, I think that's how you say it, which is a synthetic hair instead of mink hair. I mean, of course they say that they're, you know, gentle and they don't, it's like not animal cruel or anything like that. But it does feel better to buy synthetic hair instead of real animal hair. So yeah, that's why I chose the Ersatz. And these are the Provocative, I think. And they're dramatic. Really dramatic. I'll show you how they look like. They're like so fluffy, like so long. And thick and voluminous. I haven't tried them on yet. Maybe I'll insert a clip on that or just like a zoomed in one for you. But they do look very promising, and I like them a lot. I just haven't worn these kind of dramatic lashes in a while, so we'll see what they look like on. But I'm very interested in these, so yeah. Can't really tell you what I think about them yet. That's the Provocative from Flutter Lashes. Okay. So the Flutter Lashes were $9.95, which is not a whole lot for like these kind of quality lashes. I haven't used them yet, but I think they're better quality than like the drugstore one, like the Ardell and stuff like that. They feel better like to the touch. So yeah, I'm very interested in these. And then the pointed, oh, this is what it's called. It's called the pointed Pro Pointed Blender. So it's for the eyes. And it is $7.99. And the 4M433 is $5.99, so about $6. And then the Oval Shadow is $4.99. So they're really, really cheap brushes, I think, for the quality. And I did get the palette for $22.99. Which is like crazy. I just don't really get it. But shipping from the US was $23.80. And then when I picked it up at the post office here in Sweden, I had to pay another $15. Thanks. Thanks a lot. Really appreciate it. Even though my total of just the products were 47, my total for shipping and everything was 71, which feels not so great. But I don't really buy from Morphe that often, so I kind of think it's worth it. But if you don't want to spend that money, I totally get it. Yeah, so that's all I got from the Morphe website. And now I'm just going to show you what I got at Sephora here in Gothenburg, where I live. It wasn't much, it was like two products, but anyways. First off, I got the NARS Radiant Creamy Concealer in the shade Light 2 Vanilla, which I have used a lot in my videos, so you've seen it before. Mine is running out. I barely have anything left. So I felt like I needed to buy another one, and I really like this one. It looks like this. The packaging is like really sleek and beautiful. I really like this. I don't really know what to say. Here in Sweden, I think most of the products are a bit more pricey than in like the Sephora's in America. I think it was $37 for this one here. I can check how much it was online. Okay, so the price for this one in Sweden is $37, and on the website I saw that it went for like $29 or something like that, so it is a bit of a price point different. So yeah, this is just the Radiant Creaming Concealer. It doesn't crease on the under the eyes. It has like a radiant, as it says, radiant kind of finish, which makes your eyes look really awake, which I like. So it is a good concealer. I would like to try the Urban Decay one. I just haven't really gotten to do that yet, but we'll see about that. All right, so the next item that I picked up was the Makeup Forever Ultra HD Foundation, which you probably already heard of. It's kind of popular here on the internet. But I did wanted to get a new foundation. The ones that I have are all like, always too pink or always too yellow, so I wanted a neutral one because I think I'm more in the neutral area. I'm not really sure yet. So I had the girl at Sephora just match me, and I felt like this, and she also thought that the Y235 shade was the best one for me. It is a bit more neutral. I swatched it on my hand and it really matches really nicely. I haven't used it on my face yet though. I wanted to do a whole video on that, like a first impression and review on this foundation. I just wanted to show you that I got it and what it looks like. So yeah, this is it, but this is what it looks like. And as I said, this is the shade Y235 if you were wondering. And it does feel like really nice on the back of my hand. And it does look really dewy or natural, I would say, like a natural finish. I really like this. And the lady at Sephora, or the girl, I would. So I'll tell you more about this one when I've tried it out. But I'm really excited for this, and I've heard great things about it. So I hope this will work on me. So yeah, that concludes my haul, or whatever you want to call it. I'm really excited to try all these new things out. If you like this video, please give it a thumbs up. And I'll see you in the next one. Bye-bye.